Today I have a review of the Clinique High Impact Hi-Fi Full Volume Mascara. I've been testing this for the last 2 weeks and I decided today I would film a review of it. This claims to give you instant volume of up to 230%, and the mascara formula itself is infused with fibres to give you that maximum volume. You can just see them here. So here are my lashes before, and then this is how it looks with two coats of the mascara on the top and only one coat on the bottom. So let's get started. On one eye, I'm going to apply the mascara on its own, and then on the opposite eye, I'm going to apply the mascara over a primer just so you can see how it looks on both eyes with both options. So the wand is a multi-bristled wand and it's tapered, which I love because I often find that the wands are too heavy or too large at the tip, which means that getting to my inner corner lashes can be quite messy, and also my lower eyelashes, so I love that it's tapered. The formula itself is infused with a triple oil blend of argan oil, coconut oil, and moringa oil, all aimed at conditioning and nourishing your eyelashes. And as I mentioned, that formula is also infused with black nylon fibers, which is really great at lengthening your eyelashes. The mascara is also really easy to remove off the skin. If you leave it to go dry, it just comes away with a cotton bud. So that's one coat on one eye. As you can see, it does give you instant volume, but it's definitely buildable. I know it won't be for everybody because some people don't like when the eyelashes look spidery, but when you're filming this close up, it's hard for them not to look spidery. Obviously, when you step away and view the entire face, everything looks a bit more subtle, but this is great if you really want volume and drama. So I'm going to apply a second coat and I will show you what that looks like. It's a very flexible, stretchy formula, so you will find that you're able to build this nicely without it being overly clumpy. There will be an element of thickness to the lashes because of the fibres. So I'm going to move on to my other eye. Now I want to show you this one using an eyelash primer underneath. The one I'm using is MAC, but you can use one by Lancome. Clinique also do one if you want to pair them together. Primers are a great way to make the most of your natural lashes, and I feel like this extends the life of your mascara because you're only ever applying one coat of mascara. The primer acts as your first coat in a sense. While that dries, I just thought I'd show you I'm using the Lisa Eldridge Seamless Glide Eye Pencil in Ground Coffee as my eyeliner today, just in case you're wondering. Okay, so now I've given that sort of around 30 to 40 seconds to set in place, I'm going to go in with my mascara. Now, as I said, because we've applied the primer, it's almost like the first coat of mascara, so you only need one coat of your mascara. So using less of it, it extends the life of your mascara, and the primer for me always seems to last a lot longer than a mascara in general. So having the two is a little bit more expensive, but in the long run it will make your mascara last a bit longer. So it's not a necessity, but I wanted to show you that you can achieve the same amount of volume with one coat of this mascara if you apply a primer underneath. This is a very black mascara. It contains iron oxide and pearl, which dispenses a rich pigment for an intense lash look. But if black is not your vibe, they also do a brown black version, which I think is great because not everybody loves to wear black. This is also great if you are a contact lens wearer or have sensitive eyes. It's also 100% fragrance free. So you can see the right eye looks equally as voluminous as the left, but that's only one coat because we've applied a primer underneath. So it's achievable both ways. I just think that the primer is a great way to add a little bit for longevity to your mascara. And when I say longevity, I'm not talking about wear time, I'm talking about the lifetime of your mascara. So if this would ordinarily maybe last you 6 to 8 weeks, it may last you 8 to 12 weeks with the primer. So this is how it looks with just your top set done. I'm now going to apply a coat to my lower eyelashes so you can see how it looks as a full eye mascara look. Also, so that you can see how the wand works in terms of it doesn't print down on my lower eyelashes, and if it does, it's so easy to remove. Allow it to dry as I showed you earlier, use a cotton bud and it will just come away from the skin. But because the wand is tapered, it makes applying to your lower eyelashes so simple. If you are new to mascara, the best way to apply it is to wiggle at the root and then extend the width of your mascara wand down the length of your eyelashes. I know it sounds really simple, but some people have never ever tried mascara, so hopefully this helps. A little wiggle at the root really does separate the eyelashes, and then you can extend down all those individual lashes and coat them each with mascara. As I mentioned earlier, I have found that this comes off with water no problem, especially when I'm using one of my LashBase microfiber style cloths. It just takes all of my mascara away, no problem at all. But Clinique recommend using their Take the Day Off cleansing balm or the charcoal cleansing balm, and that will remove it all for you. I'm just going to show you how flexible this mascara is, and that by moving it around, your eyelashes aren't sticking together because it's no longer tacky, and also there's no fall down. As you can see, usually with a mascara, if you do this, you'll get some fall down. There's nothing, there's no transferring, no smudging. It survived heat, it survived tears. It's such a good mascara. I'm aware some of you will not like it, you won't like the spidery finish, but for me, I don't feel like it's overly spidery. It probably feels more so because I'm up close showing you. In hindsight, I probably should have zoomed out and showed you my entire face, so I'm sorry I didn't do that. But I have shared a couple of stories on my Instagram of me wearing this, and it doesn't look spidery, it just looks so lovely and voluminous. I hope you found that review helpful. If you did, please give it a thumbs up because it really does help the algorithm. Please share it with your friends and family. I will list and link the mascara and the primer and the eye pencil in the description bar for you. If you've got any questions, leave them in the comment section. I'll do my best to come back to you. Hit the subscribe button if you are new to my channel, and I will see you in a couple of days with another video. Bye guys!